All the homies, they know what I mean. Baby, let me show you how I lean.
Like a cholo.
Lay back, bounce in the car. When we do a dance, and we do it like what?
Like a cholo.
Turn to side, elbows up, turn to side. Elbows up, turn to side. Elbows up, turn to side.
Like a cholo.
All up in the club, 10 deep. Looking for some highness, we on the creep. I need a bad one, a real freak. Find them on the dance floor, so don't sleep. Damn, I like you, but I really want her. She's that type, I can't tell. Let me get in too deep, take her back to the hotel. But right now, I'm on the move. Show this little mama how a gangster groove. I don't do a whole lot, just enough. Lean side to side, keep my elbows up like this and like that. All the girls know where the real G's at. You can find us way up in the back, watching that. The girls love how I lean, like a G to the B. Blue and white MJ's on my feet. I'm looking real good.
No matter how hard you try, you can't stop us now.
Goddamn British are invading our city and many others.
Yeah, we should kick them out. We don't want them here.
But we need to take action. We can't just speak.
Well, let's attack. There's some right there now.
You, Red Lobster, get away from our city and go back home.
We don't want you here.
Tell your king we don't want you. We don't want any of you here.
All he wants is our money.
You blood-shedding people. No. The Count people don't want you here.
No.
Go back to British.
Go back to British.
Take our money.
You know what? Take our money.
Yeah.
Take it back to
the end.
Get out.
Go back home.
Go away.
Get that.
The court is now in session. This is the trial of Virginia versus Brown. I call Mr. John Brown to the stand. Mr. Brown, you do know you're a wanted man for the previous altercations to the public welfare of our citizens.
Yes. Call.
fighter for freedom of crime. I am guilty.
How exactly did you plan to fight for freedom the day of October
16, 1859? Well, beginning, first of all, we have to remember that the Constitution states we're all equal. I just find it ironic since your government does not seem to apply the same rights to everyone. It is why I decided to take law in my own hands.
How exactly did you take law into your own hands?
Well, it all began when we went to...
When me and a group of men decided to take justice in our own hands. We decided to take Harper's Ferry Armory because it seemed a perfect spot to bring justice into the slaving South. Our men decided to use the force and we broke into the armory, regardless of the consequences. No violence was present, for we were ethical men. So we broke into the armory, no one got hurt. We abducted people, but we never attempted with our lives. However, the townspeople acted beastly. Their reaction led us to retaliate their attack. Bullets were exchanged, and lives on both fronts were lost. When the military arrived, they seized our faction and eliminated completely my group of men, with the exception of me and my sergeant to the side. We then surrendered peacefully, and the army proceeded to arrest us. However, they did it in a manner that was most brutal. Unlike the army, the brutality got us hurt as we proceeded to the prison.
And that, sir, is exactly what happened.
Okay, jury, now that you have heard his side of the story, what is your verdict? Okay, juror number one?
Guilty.
Juror number two?
Guilty.
Juror number three?
Guilty.
Juror number four?
Guilty.
Juror number five? Okay, so Mr. John Brown, you have been found guilty for the previous crime and you will be hanged. Thank you.